All right, so we're going to play around with making a bubble chart. The bubble chart's easier to make if the data is in the right order. And usually the order we want is the explanatory variable, the response variable, and then some other variable to make the size of the points vary. And you could even throw a fourth variable in there. And typically a bubble chart in Google wants four variables. So I'm going to do it first with just three variables. So I have an example of a bubble chart here in the third tab at the bottom. And so what I want to do is I want to represent percent unemployment versus murder rate. I looked at that in a previous example. And I'm going to throw
Could you repeat that order that you just stated though first?
Yes. I'll write it down in my notes here. And you'll see it when we go to make the chart too. Google asks for it in that order. So new page, Google Sheet bubble charts. And a bubble chart is a way to display multiple three quantitative variables, minimally. And it's easiest to make the bubble chart if those quantities are in the following order. The x-axis should always be the explanatory variable. The y-axis is usually what Google wants next, and that's going to be the response variable, the dependent variable. And the third one is going to be the size of the point, whatever variable I want to use for that. So minimally, I need three. And often Google says, hey, you can have another categorical variable in between here. For groups. So I'm going to show the minimal version first, and then I'll throw a group in there to show that. So we want explanatory, response, and then size. So in my original data sheet, they weren't in that order. So I just made a copy of those and just reordered them. So I'm saying I'm going to use percent unemployment to predict murders in a particular metropolitan region. This is what my data is from. I got it from the FBI. And then I'm going to make the size of the bubble the population. So this is the resulting graph we're going to try and build right here. So I'm just going to show you how I built it in Google. Notice that every point is a different color. We'll see why that is once we make it. So to make it, I need my data in the right order, and then I highlight my data. So whenever we make a chart, it's usually easiest to highlight the data first, and then say, hey, have a chart, please. And then the kind of chart we're gonna make is down by scatter, and the next one over is a bubble chart. So a bubble chart is a scatter plot, but with one or two more variables. You can add another quantitative variable and a categorical variable if you want. So we select bubble chart. Then we have to make sure we have the right data. So now I go look back at x-axis, y-axis, the series, and the size. That out of the way. So I wanted the x-axis to be percent unemployment. It gave it to me. If it didn't give me that, then I click there and pick the right one. Okay, so I did want percent unemployment there. Murders, I want to be the y-axis. That's my response variable. So if it didn't pick it, you can click there and then pick it. Now, as far as the series goes, it wants a series, and the only thing left is population, so I'm just going to leave that there. But I want the size to be population also. So then I click add size, and then I pick population. Now, it gives me this legend right here, which is each color is a population. That's not meaningful. So I'm just going to go and get rid of that legend. And then it's a matter of going in and putting better titles. So put a better title at the top. Google just grabs the three variable names and throws them up there. That's not necessarily a good name. So you got to think about that. And if you want a subtitle, and then we add better names in the bottom and the side. So that's the easy version of the bubble chart. I just make sure that it put the explanatory variable X, the response variable Y. Google requires also in the setup a series, and the series here is a quantitative variable, sorry, categorical variable typically for grouping, but it could be any other variable. If it is a quantitative variable, it's not usually going to be very meaningful. So notice that when I had population in there, it gave me this legend that told me the population for every color. That's no use. What I want to just see is the population as the size. Okay, so that's the first draft of that. Now, next I want to show just a better way to use series, what this was intended for by the Google people. So over here at the bottom, I have another tab. And what I added was just a different column here. So I sorted my data by population, and then I just decided that, hey, if it's under 600,000 people, then we're just going to call that region a small metropolitan region. If it was between, and these, I just made these arbitrary just to get something in there. If it's between 600,000 and like around 160,000, sorry, 1,600,000, we'll call that a medium-sized metropolitan area. And then anything above that's just a large metropolitan area. And this is what they intended, some kind of categorical variable like this for the series. So now if I highlight all four of these and I say, make me a bubble chart, and it rarely picked the right chart for you, just go find bubble. This time it's color coding them differently. So whereas in the previous one, everything got its own color because every single population is different. That's why they're all color different. Here, I picked categories and it's coloring by category. So small is blue, medium is red, and yellow is large. So now I have some meaning to the colors, and I definitely need a legend this time. And then if I go to edit, I can do things like, usually I like the legend to be off to the right. See that. And then I need better titles, top, bottom, and side. So that's what I would do next, go in and put appropriate titles for what this data means to somebody. And I picked this data for a couple of reasons. It does seem to show a linear correlation between let's put my titles in, percent in poverty of a particular region. And my y-axis is murders per 100,000 people. So this would be, usually when we put a title, it's related to the response variable versus the explanatory variable. So I would usually write a title something like murders per 100,000 versus percent poverty. Title there. Oh, that ended up in the wrong spot. I'm all kinds of trouble. So that is supposed to be vertical. There we go. That's a little bit better. And again, there's that correlation. And sometimes we might even, you know, throw the line in there too, but I don't think I want it here in this bubble chart. We can kind of see there's a trend there. So bubble charts are powerful because they allow us to do more than two variables. I can throw a second variable, a third variable, sorry, for the size of each bubble, and then I can also categorize them, which is kind of nice too. And there's lots of different kinds of categories I could have. It could be maybe regions of the country, like Northeast, Northwest, and so on, for these metropolitan regions. Okay, that's what we got for today. We are done with chapter 2.